kind of talking my way through this smoothie. No, don't do that, buddy. So I just talked about lifting, and you're being very nosy, and that's okay. So I want to lift the skin or keep the skin taut and keep the blade flat against the skin. Yes, I know you're licking because it's itchy. I know, yes, I know. Oh, please tell me you don't have to.
It's just a mold.
So little by little, I'm working down the body. Now, at the back of the arm, there's loose skin here too, but it's matted. So we have to, I'm only using this much of the blade, mm-hmm. not the whole blade, to minimize my chances of touching the skin. Stop. So, now you can see here, this is all, hey, stop. They gotta see, stop. They gotta see. So this is all knotted, and you can tell somebody's cut away some of the knots, but there was a reason why they didn't do up in here, is because you typically, is one of the areas you're gonna cut your dog. So, twisting the skin away from the armpit. No, 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 stop. No licking, no, you can't get the equipment, no. You can't lick the equipment, it'll cut your tongue.
Ah, sorry.
Yeah.
Such a licky dog.
Well, it's itchy. The skin is, the matting creates, a pulling and tugging, and it ends up restricting oxygen and blood flow. So when we remove it, especially on a dog that's light colored like this, white, stop. I know.
You got nothing under his
chin. I got most of them, but we're going to give them a lap first.
Stop.
Oh, buddy.
I know.
So I'm trying to find ways to attack it without... No, it's a weird place. So I'm using my finger as a backdrop for the blade, so that way I can hold the skin and stop. The elbow is like the worst place, but there's no fat there. You're fine. He's not. He just does, you know, if you do that, people stop. Yes, they learn that. Yes, we know. I know all your tricks. Okay, so back to the body. So you can see how this wraps. Excuse me. No, you're fine. This is loose. You're not choking.
My dog is loose all the time.
Rub the throat, rub the larynx, and that. If he did, like, swallow his own spit and it went in the wrong hole, just like you or I. So you see, if I don't use any tension, the whole skin, all of the skin moves, and you don't want that because you're more at risk of catching the skin in the blade. So keeping it taut and moving ever so slightly back and forth, you have better control of what's happening under that blade. That's warm, so can you hand me the blade that's upside down? Right on the end, right over there. Up the other one. Switch it with this. Put that one upside down. Yep. Okay. And the blade, and see with a cool blade, you can go through better, and that's the other thing. The blades are going to cut better when they're cooler. So I have, and my staff have, multiples of each length for that reason. You don't want your blade to be more than ever, you don't want it to ever get more than like a norm to the cut. because if it gets too long, the blade starts to dull and it starts to not cut properly. So this tuck up area here is another area that gets caught. So I'm going to put my fingers on the inside of the leg so that I can feel where, and I'm going to go this way. I'm not going to follow the contour of the dog. I'm going to flip down away from the body so there's less chance of me catching that little flap of skin. Yes, I know, it's itchy. I know, it's itchy. It is. Eating elements, so I'll ask that question when I'm around to a month. The tuck up area, can't tell because of all the matting. So I can feel it. Part of grooming is feeling your way through the groom and around the dog. You always want to have contact. Young looking dog. Poodle and Maki. So the first kind of doodles, a Maki poo, a cockapoo. The difference with these guys being mixed with a poodle, Maltese and poodle, the hair structure is similar. Mm-hmm. Malteses have hair, poodles have hair, as opposed to taking a lab on a poodle, which is fur follicle, and undercoat with hair. So that's where it don't perform as you would expect. Have the butt. And you got stuff on the butt.
He's not gonna like that.
No, he's not gonna like. So hold this front end, hold those front shoulders. Because this is, I'm gonna use my 5-in-1 blade on my Commando wall. And in the sanitary. Tail away. Fingers are in between the legs so that I can feel where the blade is against the body. And this is on a 30 because of how tight and how sensitive this area is. And I'm not using a lot of pressure on the skin. So, this is the rough haircut for this little guy. And this was the outside of the coat. And this is what was all up against the inside. It's the body that we had to cut away.
Yes. He's such a good boy.
So, I'm going to be handsome. I got my smoothie on, right?
Yes. Good boy.
Happy customer.